إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا جميعا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. يقول الله عز وجل في محكم كتابه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. فأوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله. هي كما عرف الإمام علي بن أبي طالب: خوف من الجليل عمل بالتنزيل واستعداد ليوم الرحيل ورضاء بالقليل. ثم أما بعد، all praises due to Allah Azza wa Jal, He's the most merciful, most beneficent, and we send peace and blessings to the last messenger of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In Surah Yusuf, Allah Azza wa Jal says: نحن نقص عليك أحسن القصص بما أوحينا إليك هذا القرآن. Allah Azza wa Jal says in Surah Yusuf: we relate to you, O Muhammad, the best stories by the revelation of this Quran. One third of the Quran that was revealed to Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, is stories. Stories about the good and evil, prophets and messengers, good people and bad people. And Allah Azza wa Jalla related these stories so that we reflect on them and we learn from them. One of the stories that was related in the Quran is the story of Fir'aun and Musa, our beloved Prophet Musa alayhi salam. And this story was related in more than 30 surahs of the Quran. Hundreds of verses were revealed that spoke about what happened between Musa and Fir'aun. In Surah Al-Qasas, Allah Azza wa Jalla says: إن فرعون علا في الأرض وجعل أهلها شيعا. Allah Azza wa Jal says about Fir'aun and describes Fir'aun that Fir'aun, the Pharaoh of Egypt, علا في الأرض, exalted himself in this earth. And علا في الأرض gives the indication that Fir'aun at the time, he's got all the power, all the authority. He was the one who was making the law, and at the same time he's the one who's breaking his own law and bending whatever he comes up with. He was the source of authority at the time. Greatest army, wealth, he's got everything. وَجَعَلَ أَهْلَهَا شِيَعًا. Allah Azza wa Jal, when he described Fir'aun, in order to understand, because each and every, in each and every place, each and every time, there's always a Fir'aun. And Allah Azza wa Jal in the Quran describes Fir'aun so that we can understand who is Fir'aun, who is the evil one, and who is the good one. وَجَعَلَ أَهْلَهَا شِيَعًا. وَجَعَلَ أَهْلَهَا شِيَعًا means he started to go to the people of the earth at time, and he started to divide them into factions. This land is called Syria. This land is called Jordan. This land is called Egypt. This land is called Sudan. And by the way, the one who's done that is not an Arab or a Muslim or a Sudani who sat down with an Egyptian in order to come up with these and draw these maps. It wasn't done by any of these people. It was done by an authority from outside. وَجَعَلَ أَهْلَهَا شِيعًا. The first thing that Fir'aun does is he divides the people into factions. يَسْتَضْعِفُ طَائِفَةً مِّنْهُمْ. And he does that in order to make it easy for him so that he can oppress one by one. He can go to Vietnam, he's done. Now we can go to Korea, we are done. Now we can go to Afghanistan, we are done. Now we can go to Iraq. Now we can go to Palestine and Gaza. And after that we go into Saudi and Riyadh. And after that we're going to destroy Egypt and Cairo. يستضعف طائفة منهم. He always target one of these factions. He's got the power, by the way, to attack more than one. But he is somehow calculative in the way he does his things, in the way he do his things. So he does, he as if he enjoys oppressing others. It takes him time. He likes to do it, and he likes to take all the time needed in order to do what he has to do and oppress. يستضعف طائفة منهم يذبح أبناءهم ويستحيي نساءهم. And Allah Azza wa Jal described that Fir'aun, usually the majority of those who are killed and those who are affected by Fir'aun are usually أبناءهم نساءهم. Every Fir'aun on the face of this earth, the majority of those who are going to be affected by what he's doing and by his oppression are the kids and the women. Fir'aun is not strong. Fir'aun does not go an army to an army. Fir'aun always, if you look at any Fir'aun, in order to know if he is Fir'aun or not, look at those who are dying. Look at those who are affected by what Fir'aun is doing, and you will find always that the majority of those who are affected are what Allah Azza wa Jal described in Surah Al-Qasas, يُذَبِّحُ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ وَيَسْتَحْيِي نِسَاءَهُمْ. He's always good when it comes to kids and babies and when it comes to women. Allah Azza wa Jal in Surah Al-A'raf, in order to understand more about Fir'aun and how he operates, وَقَالَ الْمَلَأُ مِنْ قَوْمِ فِرْعَوْنَ أَتَذَرُ مُوسَى وَقَوْمَهُ لِيُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Now each and every Fir'aun has a Mala', and the Mala' is the small controlling minority. They are the people of power, policy makers and media. And usually they are more aggressive than Fir'aun himself. So the Mala' of Fir'aun, وَقَالَ الْمَلَأُ مِنْ قَوْمِ فِرْعَوْنَ أَتَذَرُ مُوسَى وَقَوْمَهُ لِيُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Now the Mala' are more aggressive than Fir'aun himself. They are pushing Fir'aun to do something. They want Fir'aun to completely wipe out the good people. They want Fir'aun to take an atomic bomb and a nuclear bomb and just completely wipe out the population of Gaza. Fir'aun has got a Mala', and the Mala' are the ministers, the Mala' are the media, the Mala' are the policy makers, and they are usually more aggressive than Fir'aun himself. أَتَذَرُ مُوسَى وَقَوْمَهُ لِيُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Now remember that the Mala' of Fir'aun are part of the policy making during the time of Fir'aun. And they know that their Fir'aun has been oppressing for more than 75 years and has been occupying for more than 75 years. Fir'aun himself at the time of Musa alayhi salam was the biggest mufsid in the earth, the biggest or the greatest corrupt man on the face of earth. Remember what Fir'aun used to do. One year, he slaughtered all the babies that were born. Like imagine, just imagine and reflect. And the Mala' is not talking about the fasad of Fir'aun, they are talking about the fasad and the corruption of Musa alayhi salam. أَتَذَرُ مُوسَى وَقَوْمَهُ لِيُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَيَذَرَكَ وَآلِهَتَكَ قَالَ سَنُقَتِّلُ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ وَنَسْتَحْيِي نِسَاءَهُمْ. Now when the Mala' spoke to Fir'aun, they spoke about Musa and his people. But Fir'aun, when he responded to the Mala', what did he say? قَالَ سَنُقَتِّلُ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ. Again, Allah Azza wa Jal is pointing something very important. قَالَ سَنُقَتِّلُ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ. We're going to kill their kids, their children, the offspring. This is what Fir'aun always does. وَنَسْتَحْيِي نِسَاءَهُمْ. The main two groups that's going to be affected and killed and slaughtered are the kids, the children, and the women. وَإِنَّ فَوْقَهُمْ قَاهِرُونَ. Now Musa alayhi salam said to his people, قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ اسْتَعِينُوا بِاللَّهِ. Seek assistance in Allah Azza wa Jal. وَاصْبِرُوا, and be patient. Seek assistance in Allah Azza wa Jal. Now this is the duty of the leader. This is the duty of the Nabi. When he is facing Fir'aun, and he starts to see the threats coming up from Fir'aun and his Mala', and the policy makers and the media, immediately he says to his people, استعينوا بالله. Seek assistance and help in Allah Azza wa Jal. واصبروا and be patient. إن الأرض لله. And now he takes them outside the box of how many we have and how many do they have. How many tanks on our side and how many tanks on their side. How many F-16 and F-35 they have and how many not. He takes them outside the box of the dunya. And he says to them, إن الأرض لله. The earth is Allah's. The earth is not Biden's. The earth is not Netanyahu's. And the earth at the same time is not for the believing men and women unless they are muttaqeen. وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And the good ending is for the muttaqeen. The ones who fear Allah Azza wa Jal. Now, Fir'aun, is he going to stop? No. Allah Azza wa Jal describes why. Now Fir'aun is used to break the people and divide them into factions and groups. And target and oppress each and every one. And he's not used to someone standing for him and not bending for him. So in Surah Al-Shu'ara, Fir'aun takes it and starts swearing. And now that he's backed by his ministers and by his mala, he goes, وَأَرْسَلَ فِرْعَوْنُ فِي الْمَدَائِنِ حَاشِرِينَ in Surah Al-Shu'ara. Now Fir'aun will go to the Mada'in. Does Fir'aun need the Mada'in? Does Fir'aun need UK and Italy and France and United States? Does he need any help from any other army? No, he doesn't. He's got everything. Fir'aun has got already the largest and the biggest army. It's enough to wipe out Musa and his people and maybe 10 or 20 or 30 people like him. But Fir'aun is weak. And his cause is not just. وَأَرْسَلَ فِرْعَوْنُ فِي الْمَدَائِنِ حَاشِرِينَ. Now Fir'aun starts to call in the Mada'in and the different nations and the different cities. حَاشِرِينَ, come. Come with whatever you can come up with. I need everything, the money. I need the F-35s and F-15s. I need more and more. وَأَرْسَلَ فِرْعَوْنُ فِي الْمَدَائِنِ حَاشِرِينَ. إِنَّ هَؤُلَاءِ لَشِرْذِمَةٌ قَلِيلُونَ. They are just a small minority of people. They are nothing. They are just a shirdima. We are going to wipe them out from the face of earth. And they are qalilun. If they are qalilun, why do you, ya Fir'aun, go and seek assistance? Fir'aun, his cause is not just. He wants to feel good about himself. And in order to feel good, he needs people on his side. He needs as many people. And by the way, it really hurt them when they see people coming and voicing and saying no for their oppression. It really angers them deep inside. إِنْ هَؤُلَاءِ لَشِرْذِمَةٌ قَلِيلُونَ وَإِنَّهُمْ لَنَا لَغَائِظُونَ. And we are angered about them. They are not bending. They are not doing what we are asking them to do. وَإِنَّهُمْ لَنَا لَغَائِظُونَ. And we are angered because of their actions. Because of them resisting for 75 years the occupation and oppression. وَإِنَّهُمْ لَنَا لَقَائِضُونَ وَإِنَّا لَجَمِيعًا حَاذِرُونَ. And he's speaking like a statesman. You know, when he go to the UN, Biden and Netanyahu, and they speak, the fara'een of this time, they speak and they say, وَإِنَّا لَجَمِيعًا حَاذِرُونَ. We are cautious. We don't want this battle that we have and this issue that we have to spread in any other part of this earth. We are hadirun. We are cautious that if it spreads outside Gaza, it can cause problems and corruption to the earth. وَإِنَّا لَجَمِيعًا حَاذِرُونَ. We are all cautious of the consequences of spreading this issue that we have in order to convince them to watch and seek silence. Riyadh is watching and silent. Cairo, Egypt is watching and silent. And by Allah, those who are going to live 10 years from now, by Allah, what happened in Baghdad in Iraq will happen in Cairo, Egypt. And by Allah, what's happening in Gaza will happen in Riyadh, Saudi. And when it happens, the others are going to stay silent the way they stood. They stayed silent when Gaza was slaughtered and Baghdad was slaughtered and Afghanistan was slaughtered and Vietnam, even though they're non-Muslims, who no one accepts the zulm and oppression of anyone. When Vietnam was slaughtered and the Koreans were slaughtered. وَإِنَّا لَجَمِيعًا حَاذِرُونَ. Now, Musa alayhi salam, So that Pharaoh started to prepare himself. It's coming. Musa alayhi salam is the leader. Allah Azza wa Jal describes him in Surah Yunus. قال موسى لقومه قال موسى يا قوم إن كنتم آمنتم بالله. Musa said, Oh my people, if you sincerely believe in Allah, فعليه توكلوا. Now put your trust in Allah Azza wa Jal. توكل on Allah Azza wa Jal. Put your trust fully and completely on Allah Azza wa Jal. He knows that no one is going to come and help. He knows that they have been already divided. He knows that there is some with Fir'aun and no one will come to help. So قال موسى يا قوم إن كنتم آمنتم بالله. If you sincerely believe in Allah Azza wa Jal, فعليه توكلوا. They put your trust in Allah Azza wa Jalla إن كنتم مسلمين. If you believe in Allah, and if you did really submit to Allah Azza wa Jal, then put your trust in Allah Azza wa Jal. قال موسى لقومه إن كنتم آمنتم بالله فعليه توكلوا إن كنتم مسلمين. قالوا على الله توكلنا. They said, we put our trust in Allah Azza wa Jal. قالوا على الله توكلنا. ربنا لا تجعلنا فتنة للقوم الظالمين. They are مؤدبين. Iman has changed them from the inside. They didn't even ask Allah Azza wa Jal for victory, by the way. They didn't say, Oh Allah, unsur us. They said, لَا تَجْعَلْنَا فِتْنَةً لِلْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ لِلْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ means, Oh Allah Azza wa Jal, do not make Fir'aun defeat us. Because if he defeats us, this is going to be a trial for the people. Because they might think that Fir'aun defeated us and slaughtered us and killed us because he is right and we are wrong. ونجنا برحمتك من القوم الكافرين. And oh Allah Azza wa Jal, save us with your mercy from the kafirin that we're dealing with. فلما تراء الجمعان, again in Surah الشعراء. Now تراء الجمعان is the two armies are there. They can see each other. It's not two armies, to be honest. It's جمعان. There's an army on one side and on the other side is Musa alayhi salam. There's the army of the Fara'in and there's Gaza on the other side. فلما تراء الجمعان قال أصحاب موسى إنا لمدركون. Now أصحاب موسى, the people of موسى, they said إنا لمدركون. We going to be wiped out from the face of earth. We going to be killed. Let's prepare ourselves for the shahada. It's the shahada. Let's prepare ourselves and our wives and our kids for the shahada. And by the way, that doesn't mean that they do not have iman in Allah Azza wa Jal. They have the iman, a sincere iman in Allah, but they looking at what they have and what Fir'aun has on the other side. So from a dunya perspective, they accepted the shahada. They accepted the shahada. They're going to fight until the last man and the last woman is standing. But they do not believe that there's only anything that can happen that can save them from Fir'aun and his army. إِنَّا لَمُدْرَكُونَ قَالَ كَلَّا. No. كلا. By Allah, it will never happen to Gaza. كلا. By Allah Azza wa Jal, it will never happen. كلا. إن معي ربي سيهدين. Allah Azza wa Jal is on my side. إن معي ربي. Now that they did the tawakkul on Allah Azza wa Jal, and now that they did the isti'ana, seek assistance in Allah Azza wa Jal, and they have the tawakkul in Allah Azza wa Jal, and they have the sincere iman and submission to Allah Azza wa Jal, قال كلا إن معي ربي. Allah is on my side. Allah Azza wa Jal, my Lord, is on my side. Allah Azza wa Jal, مدبر الكون, is on my side. كلا إن معي ربي سيهدين. Allah will guide me. Allah Azza wa Jal will guide me outside of what's happening. And by Allah, we believe in the same, that the same will happen to our brothers and sisters in Gaza. إِنَّ مَعَهُمْ رَبُّنَا سَيَهْدِيهُمْ. Allah Azza wa Jal is on their side, and Allah Azza wa Jal is going to guide them, and Allah Azza wa Jal is going to save them. أقول ما قلت وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا والصلاة والسلام على الموعود رحمة للعالمين السراج المنير محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. What's happening in Gaza is sometimes really hard. Sometimes made some of the brothers come to me and say, I couldn't sleep the whole night. It never happened to me in 10, 20 years. People sometimes are in despair because of the amount of blood that has been shed. Because of what they see from their politicians and media. And they have all the right to be annoyed and to be angry about what's happening. But I want to remind you something. Remember that the earth is Allah's. إِنَّ الْأَرْضَ لِلَّهِ. The one who is in control is Allah Azza wa Jal. Remember that the one who is in control is Allah Azza wa Jal. The 100 million cells that makes the body of Biden or Netanyahu came together because Allah Azza wa Jal made them come together. The lung that he's got and the heart that he's got has been beating and breathing, and the aql that he's got, and everything is controlled by Allah Azza wa Jal. One artery and that's it. You won't be able to stand on your feet or speak or do anything like any other human being. So number one, remember that Allah Azza wa Jal is in charge of this kawun. And secondly, remember that you have a duty as a Muslim. Allah Azza wa Jal does not want the believing men and women to panic. He wants you to be a man composed, especially in the hard times. Allah Azza wa Jal wants you to be composed. It's okay that you have tears. When the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, when his son died, he had the tears. إِنَّ الْعَيْنَ لَتَدْمَعَ. Tears in my eyes. قَلْبَ لَيَحْزَنَ. Grief in my heart. But at the same time, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is composed. And once he did the dafn, he went back to his life and his da'wah as a prophet and as a messenger. Muslim is composed. The Muslim in the hard times is composed and he knows what he's doing. Because he's got yaqeen in Allah Azza wa Jal. He completely relies and depends on Allah. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants you. Remember the hadith. That if the day of judgment is coming, you see it. You knew, that's it. It's going to start. What to do? What did the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam order you to do? If you have a fasila, a seed or a small plant, what to do? Put it in the ground. What does that mean? Like, think about it. Qiyamah is going to start. And I have a fasila, a seed, or a small plant. Why put it in the ground? What's the benefit? Am I going to eat from the fruits of this plant? No. Am I going to benefit anything from this plant? No. The message is, even if Yawm al-Qiyamah, and this is definitely the scariest moment in the life of each and every human being. Even if Yawm al-Qiyamah is about to start, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam does not want you to panic and run. He wants you to be composed, take the fasila, put it down in the ground and fix it, even though there is no natija. Even though that you know the result is nothing, the benefit is nothing, the fruits are nothing. You are not going to get anything from this fasila. But Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is sending a message. As a believer, as a man, as a woman, you have to be composed in the hard times and not panic. And this is how we should, dear respected brothers, deal with the asthma, with the issue that we have today for our brothers and sisters in Palestine. We will make dua for them. We might cry. We might boycott some companies that support the genocide. We might go and protest in the city. We might do some jihad with our money and support our brothers and sisters so that they can continue on the resistance. But at the same time, we're going to stay composed. We're not going to show any weakness to anyone. We're not going to show, because this is what they want to see. The enemies of Islam, they want to see that weakness in what we do and what we say. No, we are composed. We are going to control our anger. And we are going to control our emotions. And we are going to stay composed. And we know that we have a tariq. There's a path. The path of Allah Azza wa Jal. The path of sabr. The path of jihad. The path of the Quran.
the path of aqeedah, the path of iman. This is a long path. It ends when you meet Allah Azza wa Jal. فَإِمَّا نُرِيَنَّكَ in Surah Al-Rum, Allah Azza wa Jal speaking to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to make it clear even to the Prophet of Islam. فَإِمَّا نُرِيَنَّكَ الَّذِي نَعِدُهُمْ. So we might show you, Ya Muhammad, what we have promised you, which is the victory. And we will show you, O Muhammad, the signs. We might show you. أَوْ نَتَوَفَّيَنَّكَ. Or you might die, O Muhammad, and not see anything. فَإِلَيْنَا يُرْجَعُونَ. And then remember Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that the most important thing is that you and them are going to return to us. The ones who oppressed the Sahaba, and the Sahaba that were oppressed, the companions that were oppressed. The one who killed the Sahaba and the Sahaba that were killed, where are they now? Raja'u ila Allah. They all return to Allah Azza wa Jal. فَإِمَّا نُرِيَنَّكَ الَّذِينَ عَدُهُمْ. We might see the Nasr with our eyes in this life, and we might not see it and die before we see the Nasr, but our yaqeen and iman in the promise of Allah Azza wa Jal is not going to be shaken. We're going to stay composed and strong and optimistic about the outcomes of what's going to happen in Gaza. And the last thing is, by Allah, by Allah, by Allah, the bravest Muslims that I've met in my whole life, they're not like the Palestinians outside. No offense to the Palestinians outside Palestine. Because I'm attached to the dunya. I'm the guy who's attached to the dunya. Business, money, and what I'm doing, and the car, and the house, is 95% of my life. And 5% is da'wah. Give 1-2 hours for the sake of Allah Azza wa Jal. But 95% of my life is dunya. And this is like anyone else. We are occupied. We are the only ones that are free are the people of Gaza, by the way. And everyone else, the 1.7 billion Muslims, they are occupied, at least by our shahawat and desires here in this planet, in this country that we're living in. By Allah, the bravest Muslims and the smartest Muslims that I've met in my whole life, and I've been to lots of countries, I've dealt with lots of Muslims, lots of jama'at, from different jama'at, all the jama'at, but by Allah, the bravest, the strongest, and the smartest people that I've ever met are the people of Gaza. When I visited them 10 years ago, Ya Allah, these people know what they do. They know the consequences of what they do. But they're not like us. They're not going to accept to be occupied and stay silent. They're not going to take a permission from anyone to resist. They're not going to wait. They prefer to die than to live oppressed or stay oppressed under the occupation of Israel. هذا وصلى وسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين السراج المنير محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. أمر الله عز وجل بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه ثنى بملائكته المسبحة بقدسه فقال إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على الحبيب المصطفى محمد. ارض اللهم عن ساداتنا أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن الصحابة أجمعين وعن التابعين وتابعين بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وعز المسلمين. اللهم أعلي بفضلك كلمة الحق والدين. اللهم انصر عبادك المجاهدين الموحدين في كل مكان. اللهم انصر إخواننا في غزة. اللهم انصر إخواننا في غزة. اللهم اهدي إخواننا في غزة. اللهم يا ربنا برحمتك أنزل نجاة من عندك على إخواننا في غزة. اللهم يا ربنا تقبل شهداءهم، داو جرحاهم، اكس عاريهم، وأطعم جائعهم يا رب العالمين. ثبت الأرض من تحت أقدامهم، اهدهم إلى أفضل الأفعال والأقوال، لا يهدي لأفضلها إلا أنت. اللهم احفظ علينا في هذا البلد ديننا وأمننا وأعراضنا وأموالنا. اللهم استر علينا بناتنا وزوجاتنا. اللهم اهد لنا أبناءنا وشبابنا. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وأقم الصلاة.